Hey, what's up guys, Totally Dubbed here, and today I'm going to try and answer, is buying a more expensive cable actually worth it? So you'll be able to see, potentially on my desk, and I'm going to zoom in a second, of a cable for my earphone, a cable for my amplifier, an extension cable, and even a cable that is on my headphone. So in terms of audio wise, I'm trying to cover as much as I can, and I've even got speaker wires at the back of my Celestion speakers. The reasoning behind this video is because I got sent a extension cable and I was wondering what is the sound quality difference between this and my Amazon Basics cable, and there wasn't any. However, as soon as I plugged in another cable, which is the Epiphany Acoustics MJ2 cable, I heard a difference. And I want to explain that. So, I had a little test scenario up. I had my Denon X500 receiver connected via optical to my PC. Off that, I had a quarter inch adapter, which had a splitter which were gold ended on both ends. And off that, I had the Amazon Basics cable, which can be bought for about £1.50. And then on the other end, I had the the Epiphany Acoustics MJ2 cable, which costs around £14. Then I was literally plugging in and plugging out my headphones, which are the Denon AHD2000, which have been modified with a D5000 cup and has been dampened, and has a custom-made D7000 cable, which has been re-terminated with a 3.5mm jack, and has Lawton audio pads, but that's got nothing to do with the cables or the audio quality. So I was trying to do that test with these headphones and I actually noticed the difference. So let's zoom in to the actual headphones and the cables so it gives you a better idea of what I'm talking about. So as you can see down here, I had the MJ2 cable, which is the one in red, and I had the Amazon Basics cable, which is the one in black. So as you can see over here, the MJ2 cable doesn't come standard with a 3.5mm female jack, therefore I had to put a female-to-female jack on that in order to complete this test. So what was the differences between these two cables? Well, apart from the £12 odd difference, there was not much. However, the mid-range of the Epiphany Acoustics one was a little bit fuller. It sounded much more clearer and therefore was a better audio experience. Therefore, to pretty much put it in short, this cable was better than that cable. However, was it worth £10? Well, that depends on how you see it. For me, audio is in little steps. You've got your headphones, you've got your amplifiers, you've got your cables, heck, you've even got your source and you've got your music. There's a lot of variables in audio. Cables are one of those that loads of people see either way. They are like, oh, it's too expensive, or, oh yes, a £50 cable is definitely warranted for my setup, or even a £1,000 cable is warranted for my setup. It really depends. But for me, the way I see it, it's quite simple. If we're talking about a headphone setup, so you've got your headphone, you've got your actual source, you've got your potential amplifier, portable amplifier, and you've got your interconnect or wire that's needed for it, this is the way I rank it. Your headphone is going to be the most important. That's probably going to provide 80% of the difference in terms of sound over a different type of headphone. Then you've got your amplifier, which for me brings about 15 to 18% of that difference. The source is also important, but let's not factor that in. And let's say the actual source music, i.e. is it FLAC or is it 320 kb or is it 256 or whatever, let's not factor that in either. And let's say that the cable is the last 2%. So that is how I would rank it. Headphone being an 80% difference, a amplifier being 18% or to 15% different, and then a cable being that final refinement between 5 and 1%. So that is, for me, what a cable really brings. It's that little refinement in sound. Now, why does that happen? Now, a lot of people try and do different theories in terms of saying, oh, maybe because a cable is better made, or it's simply because it's shielded or something like that. Well, that's wrong. The difference between a cable, between say this cable and that cable, is due to its materials that's used within the cable. And what does that mean? Well, if a cable is made, let's say, of pure silver, and then a cable is made of pure copper, the difference is the metals. And the metals, the way they conduct, be it electricity, heat, or even a source in terms of a music sound, is going to be different simply because of how the metal is made and how the metal conducts electrical energy. So I'm not going to get technical into this, and on top of that, I can't get into technical because I am not that technically minded to give you all graphs and equations of how one is better than the other or vice versa. But what I'm going to tell you is that metals have different conduction, and I think pretty much at any basic level or at school, you're probably going to be taught that. Some metals react better than others, and in this case, it's same for cables. But then how does that affect the sound quality? Well, if a cable has a lower resistance or a different type of conduction to it, it's going to be able to produce a not a better sound, but a different type of sound, a potentially more clearer sound, and therefore, due to having a more clearer sound, having a better sound overall. And in this case, this is what I think the difference is between this cable and that cable. The different materials chosen over here bring out the mid-range a little bit more, and therefore allow me to listen to music that little bit better and preferably. So in other words, I prefer using this cable over this cable due to its better mid-range response to my headphones. But then let's take it back into the equation of that cable that I received for review. Why is this cable, which is similarly priced to this cable, around this is about £10, this is about £14, why is this cable not make any difference between this? Well, it's quite simple. It could be just simple marketing, almost like Beats and Monsters and all of that, all of that jazz. This cable is probably made the same way as this Amazon Basics cable, but due to it looking cool, or due to it being shielded, and due to it having a little bit better termination, this cable is £10, and that Amazon Basics one is £1.50, and that is the difference between it. You don't get any audio difference, you just get a better look, and potentially better lifespan. That is it. However, with this Epiphany Acoustics cable, which is really, you know, made by audiophiles, should I say for audiophiles, is better made, and in terms of sound, actually sounds a little bit better. So, this makes consumers very much confused, i.e. myself. What cable do you buy? Which one do you choose? Well, all I can say is there is no right or wrong answer. Buy whichever cable you feel best for you and whichever's in your budget. If you have £10 to spend on a cable, go and look for a cable that's £10 and go and look for reviews that are going to give you an honest review. Don't look at the biased reviews. Don't look at people that are going to say, yeah, cable this, cable that, or this doesn't exist, that doesn't exist. Go and try and look for real honest reviews, and yes, it's going to be extremely hard for you to find that, but it's going to be the best thing you're going to ever do. Or, on top of that, if you can, try it before you actually buy it. Go into a shop, go and ask the company, can I try it? Go and buy it knowing that you've got a return policy that you can work on, something like that. This might be the case for you in order to try before you buy the cable, or in order to return the item if you're not fully satisfied. This is why I think consumers, like myself, should go out and do when buying cables, because it's very hard, and on top of that, it's extremely subjective and a very delicate matter in the audio industry. So, now we've got that out of the way, where can cables also be used? Well, as I said, they can also be used on my headphones. As I told you, I've got a D7000 cable, which has been custom made. The reason why it says custom made is because normally a D7000 cable is terminated with a quarter inch jack. This one is terminated with a 3.5mm jack. However, is there any audible differences between the D2000 cable and the D7000 cable? Just a FYI, the price difference between D2000 and the 7000 in terms of headphones is the £200 model, the D2000, to about an £800, £1000 model to the D7000. At least I think it's around that range. So it's a huge difference in terms of price, in terms of headphone. And supposedly the cable is better. Well, it is better in terms of not being tangled, but in terms of actually transferring sound, to me it sounded exactly the same, and it hasn't changed. So it just gives you an idea of cables are worth spending a little bit of money on, but are not worth spending an arm and a leg on, at least not in my opinion. Now let's take a different example. Let's look at an amplifier. I've got an interconnect here which was made by Custom Art, and this little interconnect I bought for about 20 or 30 odd pounds. The reason I bought it is several reasons. One of which is it's silver, secondly it's made out of silver, secondly it's got a nice termination and nice jack, and thirdly it's going to last me the while. Actually, I've owned this wire for about a year and a half and it hasn't failed me since, and it's something that I didn't notice in other cheaper basic Amazon-esque cables. On top of that, this cable brought out the mids, almost like the Epiphany Acoustics one, that slight 1 or 2% refinement for my audio portable rig, and that is something that I really liked. Now let's look at earphone cables. I've got an earphone cable over here. This is a stock Audiophonac PFE-232 cable. I haven't replaced it simply because I haven't seen the need to do it. I might just do it for the sake of doing it because this cable is starting to fall apart, and that's something else. But in terms of replacing it, I've never seen the need. Why should I? The cable is probably not going to give me that type of difference, and to replace a cable like that in a custom cable is probably going to cost me £50 to £100. Do I see fit to get a custom cable for £50 to £100? Not at all, and it's definitely not worth my trouble or my money. I'd rather save that up and buy a better phone, more music, a better amplifier, a better headphone, a better earphone, whatever it is, but definitely not a better cable, because that £100 could be spent, or £50 to £100 could be spent better elsewhere. I have reviewed an earphone called the Ultimate Ears TF10s, and I had three separate cables: stock, a Westone-esque cable, and a custom-made cable. And these three cables actually had all different sonic differences. And I can link you down in the description below of my review of that, and a honest review of those three different cables, including with the headphone and how that affected the headphone. As I said, cables do make a difference. But are they enough to justify a difference? Well, that's up to you to decide. For a TF10, yes, it was worth justifying the difference. But then when I found out the cable was about £100 to £150, which is pretty much the price of the earphone itself, I said, absolutely not, completely pointless. So, really depends on you. So hopefully this video has brought some light in terms of audio cables, if they're worth it or not, or in different setups. On top of that, I haven't even touched upon speaker cables, and the reason behind that is simply because I don't have enough experience in that, and I don't feel that commenting on something I don't have enough experience on, like other YouTubers do or other reviewers do, is something that people should do. I don't feel like commenting on that because I don't have enough speaker cables to go through or to test or have tested in the past. I'm quite a speaker newbie in that respect. So all I can say is, from experience from portable solutions or headphone solutions or interconnect solutions or something like that, I can say that I've tried a vast array of cables, and I can say there's a slight difference in better cables. But when I say better cables, I mean cables which are maybe between 10 to 20 pounds versus 1 pound or 2 pounds. I am definitely not talking about cables which are 50 to 100 pounds or even more, because there's absolutely no difference between the 10 pound one and the 100 or 200 pound one, apart for when you're talking about electromagnetic shielding. And when you're talking about that, you're pretty much talking about being in a nuclear facility or potentially being surrounded by 10,000 electronic devices all around you. So that is not the case in most households, so people don't really have to worry about all of that. Anyway guys, hopefully this video has brought enough information, a little bit of subjectivity, a little bit of objectivity, a little bit of mix and match between the two, and hopefully it's been useful. If you found it useful, make sure you like the video, and definitely favorite and share it for someone that you think this might help. On top of that, comment about your opinions below, as I really like reading your comments. So definitely let me know your thoughts about cables, let me know if you think it's worth it or not, and on top of that, let me know if you've heard of other stories. Personally, I've even heard of huge YouTubers saying sound cards are absolutely pointless, and I literally facepalmed myself and hit the desk really hard with my hand and said, "You're an idiot for saying that," and I really do believe that. how does a sound card not make a difference, and the fact that loads of people, even my mother, was able to hear a difference just begs the question. But anyway, that's a different subject and we're not talking about that, but what I'm trying to say is that let me know your comments, let me know your opinions, let me know if other people have commented on it, and it will be really interesting to hear. Alright guys, I've been Totally Dubbed. Take care. Bye-bye.